The presidential preference poll is going to start in about 2 minutes down in the cafeteria. If you want to participate in that, you can go down there, you can look at the map on the wall, find your precinct, get at the table, and participate. But this is just for if you want to be active in the local Democratic Party. It has nothing to do with Bernie or Hillary or any of that. If you want to participate, if you just are here for the presidential preference poll, then you continue in line to get your ballot and fill that out. If you go down to the caucus, we will make sure that you get a presidential ballot, preferential preference poll ballot, and you can complete that after the caucus. Is that fairly clear? I apologize that this is very confusing. Normally we do just the local caucus, but they put on top of this primary, and obviously we have 10 times the people that we normally have to one of these things, so we appreciate your cooperation. If you do want to participate in the local Democratic Party, you can go out right now and find your table and see if you can get elected for a local delegate position. But that has nothing to do with the presidential primary. The ballots that you cast say, let's just say that the ballots tonight come out 60% Bernie, 40% Hillary. Then that is how the national delegates that are going to get picked at some other event will have to vote. They're going to have to vote 60% Bernie, 40% Hillary. Or if it goes the other way, then it'll be 60% Hillary, 40% Bernie. Is our representative that is in office right now for this District 37. So everybody that's here is a constituent right now for Carol Moss. We can't tell you how to vote. She is, there is somebody running, opposing her. That all will all be decided at the conventions, and the conventions for the Democratic Party are April 9th for the Salt Lake County and April 23rd for the state. If you're elected a local delegate, and there's just a few of those spots that are given out based on your past activity in the party, you will be voting to determine who among and I think there's, at the county office, there's Ben McAdams, somebody's running against him, and you'll have to decide who represents the Democrats going against the Republican in the November election. Is that fairly clear? I hope it is. Thanks again for all your cooperation. As I've said, this is 10 times the crowd that we normally would have, and we apologize that the legislature elected not to fund the primary, and this is what we get. If anybody, their last name ends in K, or true, it just in K, there's no waiting out front to get your ballot. So you can follow this lady right here, and she'll get a check in for your ballot.
I don't know what this would have been like a running house. I'm so glad you're here. So much more enjoyable.
So, hi everyone. Thank you for your patience. And I got that we put you in this room so that you could be warm. And we got that you are in a line. So we know that you're here to get registered, or you're already registered, you just want your ballot. And that's why you're in this room. And we're going to pull you up line by line in our best way possible in the way that you came in, so that you can get into the lines for your, like, by your last name to get your ballot to vote or to caucus. So thank you all for your patience. I apologize if we miscommunicated to you, because he's doing his job. So thank you all for being here. We know that you're in a line, and we're going to do our best to, like, keep you in your lines so you can get your ballot. Is that clear for everyone? Thank you guys so much for your patience, and we just wanted you to be in here, be warm, not possible. So,
yay!
Thank you.